Did you know that over 1,500 pastors quit the ministry every single month? I want to talk to you about abiding in the vine. You see, I believe that you are called by God to do something incredible for the glory of His Son Jesus. And anyone who is called has to give of themselves to the ministry and to the Lord. They have to devote themselves. They have to sacrifice. They have to go through challenge and trial. But I want to talk to you about remaining in the source, abiding in the vine. When you abide in the power of the Holy Spirit, when you abide in the secret place of prayer, you'll not know what it is to burn out. You can walk without growing faint. You can run without growing weary. You can continue the ministry. You can continue to accomplish the work and the will of the Father here in the earth without growing weary. And this is the key: abiding in the vine. That's what I'm talking to you about today on this edition of Spirit Church here on Encounter TV. Stephen Moctezuma is here with me as usual. He's going to lead you in worship, and then we're going to get right into this very important message. I believe God wants to use you, so this is something you will definitely want to watch. Here is Stephen Moctezuma.
And He is jealous for me. He loves like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of His wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful You are and how great Your affections are for me. And oh, how He loves us. Oh, oh, how He loves us. How He loves us. Oh, and oh,
read you this quote from Leonard Ravenhill. When I read it, it really struck me, and it was one of those quotes that stuck with me from a very early age. I believe I was 13 or 14 when I first heard this, but I want you to hear this. Leonard Ravenhill says, "No man is greater than his prayer life. The pastor who is not praying is playing. The people who are not praying are straying. We have many organizers, but few agonizers. Many players and payers, but few prayerers. Many singers, few clingers. Lots of pastors, few wrestlers. Many fears, few tears. Much fashion, a little passion. Many interferers, few intercessors. Many writers, but few fighters. Failing here, we fail everywhere." Jesus said in Matthew chapter 11, "Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." The scripture says in Isaiah chapter 40, verse number 31, "But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Doing things in your own effort is as simple as living a life without prayer. So often we give of ourselves in ministry, we give of ourselves in prayer, we give of ourselves, and I'm talking about prayer for other people, we give of ourselves in preaching, we give of ourselves in teaching and in doing the work of God. And while we are giving from what we have received of the Lord, and that is a wonderful thing to do, we must at the same time be refilling ourselves daily. The scripture tells us to be filled with the Holy Spirit. And that word filled in the context in Ephesians is actually talking about a constant filling of the Holy Ghost. A constant, not hour by hour, not day by day, not week by week, but moment by moment clinging to the presence of Jesus. You see, the key to sustained ministry, the key to continuing in power without growing weary, is the daily seeking of the Lord. If you are not daily seeking the Lord, the truth is you'll run out of strength. If you are not daily in the Word, the truth is when you minister the Word, it will be dry. It will lack passion. It will lack the anointing. But when you daily tap into the source of the power of God's Holy Spirit through prayer and devotion to the Word, you are accessing something that is eternal. You are tapping into something that is energizing, that will cause you to be faithful in the ministry. I've seen so many pastors burn out. I've seen many begin this race with me, but today when I look around, they're no longer here. I've seen many become excited about ministry, become excited about preaching, and become excited about writing books or about putting out products such as audio sermons or even music. But many of those people who I've seen become excited about those very things are no longer here today. They've fizzled. They've gone out. I've seen some who begin quickly and they're off to the races, so to speak, and they are beginning in the ministry with all they have. But as time goes by, they start to lose passion. They start to lose focus. I've seen some ministers who come in, and I've been guilty of this myself, with a vision, but as the years go by, stray from that vision. I've seen men who are called to be prophets focus instead on being evangelists. I've seen men who are called to pastor churches instead focus on book writing or TV ministry. And I'm not saying that God will not call you to multifaceted ministry. In fact, I know many who to this day are still very well kept in the ministry by the Lord, and they are branched off into various parts of ministry, book writing, preaching, television production, radio, even podcasting nowadays. But the truth is that I've also seen some lose focus because of the fact that they are not daily calibrating their direction. We tend to go off track. This is just the truth. We, especially ministers, can become guilty of presumption. In other words, we think that just because we are doing something with a passion for God, that just because we are doing something with good intentions, that just because we are doing something that seems like it fits in the moment, that we are therefore doing the will of God. But the truth is, in order to walk in the will of God, in order to position you and your ministry in the center of power, in the place where God can really anoint on it and really breathe upon it, that place is found in prayer. And we remain in that place, we remain calibrated to that destination through prayer, through daily prayer, and not just daily, but moment by moment resting in the Lord. By consulting with Him, by speaking with Him, by letting him speak to you, by submitting yourself to His direction and His guidance. We must find time for prayer. We must find time to plug into that source. I remember I was ministering in a place where the hour change was drastic for me. And I'm used to jet lag. I'm used to flying from one place to another and having to adjust my hours. And usually when I go do a ministry trip, I'll give myself a day or two to really adjust, seek the mind of God, seek the face of the Lord in prayer, and then become energized again and go on doing ministry. But this time on this trip, I was so exhausted already. The week leading up to it was exhausting. I had project after project. I had book writing to do. I had to tape a couple extra programs because I was going to be gone for an extended period of time. I was receiving phone calls from people who needed counseling, and I was meeting with ministry staff and so on. There were many things that filled my week with just a lot of work. And sometimes the ministry is a lot of work. In fact, most of the time, the ministry is a lot of work. And so I was already very tired going into this trip. I get to the airport. It was an early morning flight. It wasn't supposed to be booked that early, but there was some miscommunication between my office and the church, and so they had me on a, I think it was a 5:30 a.m. flight, and that meant I had to be there 2 hours early. We're talking, you know, 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning, which means I had to leave an hour before that from my house, and it was just this very tiring trip. I go to the airport. I'm exhausted, and then I remembered there's that time change. When I landed, I had failed to remember that upon landing, I had to go immediately and preach. And so I get there, I land, I'm exhausted, I'm tired. Then the jet lag hits me. Then I have to go and preach that service. And then when I go to bed that night thinking I'm going to finally catch up on rest, I remember I have to speak in the morning. And I believe the morning service was a little earlier than I normally preach. And on top of that, I had forgotten that there was an hour change during this travel. So I lost an hour on top of everything. And I remember I said, Lord, if you don't anoint me tomorrow, I'm in trouble. If I get up on that platform and your power is not with me, I'm in trouble because I'm exhausted, Lord. I'm just so tired. And I remember when I got on that platform to preach, I felt the anointing of the Holy Spirit. It was like He carried me through the whole service. All I had to do was rest and surrender, and He took that service. And I'm telling you, paralysis was healed in that service. There was a woman who had come to the service. She was paralyzed, I believe, on her right side because of a stroke. She was healed. There was a baby who was born deaf in both ears, who the parents were able to tell if the baby could hear or not. When his hearing aids were in, he would react to noises in a certain way. When his hearing aids were out, he would not react to those noises. We prayed for him, and he began to react to the noises without his hearing aids. There was a woman there who was blind in her left eye since birth, completely made whole. And there were many miracles that took place in the presence of Jesus manifested on that building. I'm talking the power of God hit that room and people were going out under the power of God. And I remember after the service, my body felt a little drained, but at the same time, I felt this energy come upon me. And many times I have felt this energy, the anointing of the Holy Spirit is energizing. But you see, I was able to rely upon that anointing, not because I was strong, not because I was necessarily well rested. And I do recommend getting rest. That's a part of taking care of yourself. That's a part of good stewardship. That's a part of doing a good job at ministering. It just so happened in this instance that the circumstances did not allow for me to do that. But still, it wasn't because of any of that. I was exhausted. I was tired. But there was a deeper well that I was drawing from. There was a deeper place that I was tapping for my source of energy, my source of power. And that well was able to be tapped because that well was dug already in the places of prayer. Is your well ready? Or is it still covered with dirt? Is it still not flowing with water? You know, here's the thing about digging a well. Every shovel is full of dirt until you hit water. And you have to dig that well in prayer. You have to dig that well by subjecting the flesh to the things of the Spirit. And as you dig that well of prayer, as you begin to seek the face of God, you begin to remove the dirt or the flesh, and it becomes easier and easier and easier for you to access that well. And so it's there when you need it. We, and especially ministers, need to learn the power of the secret place. We need to learn the power of abiding in the vine. John chapter 15, verse 5 says, "Yes, I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing." We must remain in the source. We must stay connected to Jesus. About that well I was referencing, we dig that well every day. We dig that well every moment that we are seeking the face of Jesus. And when we seek Him in the secret place, we are clearing the way for the waters to flow so that when the time comes for you to minister, when the time comes for you to pray for other people, when the time comes for you to teach the word, when the time comes for you to give of yourself for the ministry, you're not drawing from yourself anymore. You're drawing from the well. You see, you know you're drawing from yourself when your mind gets tired. You know you're drawing from yourself when you start to feel burdened by the ministry. Listen, If you feel burdened by the ministry, you're not giving from the source. You're giving from yourself. If you feel cynical about ministering to God's people, you're not giving from the source. You're giving from yourself. If you feel exhausted after praying the power of the Holy Ghost onto people's lives, you're not giving from the source. You're giving from yourself. When we give from the source, we are energized. I want to read that verse again, Isaiah 40, 31. Let's look at this again. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. I'm not going to grow weary. I'm not going to quit. Why? Because it's not on my own strength. If I were to do what I do on my own strength, I would have quit a long time ago. But the truth is, we say I'm not doing it on my own strength. We say I trust in the Lord. We say I'm relying upon His power. But the true test of whether or not you are relying upon His power is your prayer life. If your prayer life is intact, if you are devoted to daily seeking His face, if you are devoted to a constant clinging to His presence, then the truth is, you're doing it in His strength. But if you are doing it without a prayer life, if you're ministering the Word without giving the Word from your source, then it's coming from you. You know, when I minister the Word, I can either minister from my mind to somebody's mind, and that after a while, it's informative, but it's exhausting. Or I can minister from my mind to somebody's spirit, and they'll receive it, but I'm exhausted giving it. Or I can minister from my spirit to their spirit, and it's life to both of us. Remember when Jesus ministered to the woman at the well and the disciples brought Him food? He said, I already ate. I already had my food. It's because it was to do the will of the Father. Doing the will of God fills you. It doesn't empty you. Doing the ministry fills you. It doesn't empty you. Ministering God's power energizes you. It doesn't tire you. I remember I used to be with certain ministers, and I learned a lot from them, and I'm not trying to mock them in any way, but it's funny, the memory to me. They were so dramatic after every service. Oh, I'm so tired, I'm exhausted. They would sit on the chair in the green room and just say, oh, I'm done, I'm exhausted. And they acted as if they were the ones giving the healing power. And they say, oh, I'm drained. And so I used to think like that after services. I'd say, oh, I'm drained. But you know, ask my team, after services, I'm energized, I'm ready to go. I feel more energized after the service than I do beforehand because the anointing is energizing. Your strength is to do the will of the Father. And the source of that power to accomplish the work of the Father is prayer, is the vine, is abiding in Jesus. We can't do anything apart from that. We must remain in that source. We must stay connected to Him. Don't give of yourself. Give of the Spirit. You see, the reason why you have to go and listen to other people's sermons, have to download sermons on the internet, have to get sermons on YouTube, is because you're not in the Word for yourself. The reason you so often need people to lay hands on you is because you don't have a prayer life. The flesh rises, bitterness and jealousy and depression and anxiety and all these things we allow because we're not remaining in the vine. We're not abiding in the vine. We're not staying connected to the source. So I want to challenge you today, minister of the gospel, servant of the Lord, anointed one of God, abide in the vine, remain in the source. And that promise in Isaiah is yours. Jesus said, come to me, I'll give you rest. He said, abide in me. For apart from Him, remember this, apart from Him, we can do nothing. I want to pray with you now. I want to pray that you would, let's position ourselves to just rest in the presence of the Lord. Let's just surrender in this moment. Give the ministry to Him. Give the work of the gospel to Him. Give yourself to Him. Come to Him with rest. Let Him lift your burdens. You so often pour out and pour out and pour out, and maybe you wonder, Lord, when is someone going to do this for me? Well, here, I'm doing it for you now. Let me minister to you. You sit back and you take this. And let me minister to you because you need the rest. And in the future, don't tire yourself. Don't drain yourself. Don't grow exhausted. Don't work in the ministry in a tedious way. Just abide in the source and let it flow. and you will not grow weary. So, Father, I pray for that one receiving this prayer now. And I pray, precious Holy Spirit, that you would refresh them with springs of living water. Lord, you said in your word that you will cause the dry land to become pools of water. And I pray, Lord, that the rain of heaven would sweep across their room now. And Lord, with every drop, let them be more empowered. With every drop, let the anointing intensify. With every drop, let them be energized in Jesus' name. I pray, Father, for burdens to be lifted. Lord, accomplish your will in them and through them. Help us, Lord, to abide in the vine. Thank you for your strength. Thank you for your power. Thank you for refreshing us by your Holy Spirit as only you can. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray. And I want you to say it if you agree. Say, amen. Well, that is it for the lesson. I want to welcome now the new members of Spirit Church. There you are up on the screen. We love you and we are praying for you. I always say that because I always mean it. I want to read now your comments and then I want to update you on where we are on our ministry expansion campaign. We're almost there, but I want to read the comments now. And this is from last week's video in which I talked about embracing your cross. Now, this message, you hardly hear any preaching on the cross anymore. But Jesus himself said, if you want to be my disciple, you must take up your cross. So let's look at the first comment here. Thank you for a preaching that has not been preached of late. Jesus gave us instructions on how to follow him, and most times we miss the first step, denying self. Thank you. I felt really convicted, especially in letting go and making Jesus the only thing. Thank you for obeying the Holy Spirit on what to teach today. I needed to hear this. Well, it really is his instruction. And every week I ask the Lord, okay, Lord, what do they need to hear this week? And every time he is faithful to minister his word. Catherine writes, the introduction is a complete sermon in itself. Thank you. Cecilia writes, Pastor David, you have been a blessing to me. Your teachings have helped me to live a spiritual life. You always encourage me to live a life that's praising to God. I'm watching from Kenya. Well, hello to you all the way in Kenya. I'm saying hello from Southern California. Another commenter writes, it's 10 p.m. and I stumbled to this video. God led me here somehow and it's just on time. I really need this. Thank God for leading me to find your ministry. God bless you. Another commenter writes, hi, Pastor David. I'm Roman Catholic. First time I'm hearing a born-again pastor preaching about the glory of the cross. I loved it and all your teachings, especially topics about the demonic. It gave me freedom. I can't describe it, but I feel so free now. Thank you. God bless you. And the final comment from Ian Francis says, this message is spot on and reminds me of the old time preaching a la Catherine Coleman and Billy Sunday. They did teach the resurrected life, but they also taught about suffering and the cross. Okay, I want to update you now on where we are with our ministry expansion campaign. Take a look on the screen. This is where we are. We need just under 400 new ministry partners, and then we're ready to do it. We're ready to expand. That's all we need. Sign up today to become a $30 a month partner or make a one-time donation to help other aspects of the ministry move along. Now, with this expansion, the expansion is going to be twofold. With this expansion, number one, we're going to get into a new facility. In that new facility, we'll be able to hold weekly meetings. We'll be able to do live broadcasts. We'll be able to launch a new network, not just a YouTube channel, a whole network on Top Box television set. That's Amazon TV, Apple TV, Roku, or Amazon Fire. It's called a Google Chromecast, all of the Top Box television sets. And we'll be able to have, like I said, those regular meetings. That's the big one. And then we're going to have a 24/7 prayer room, and we'll be even possibly be able to do live streaming from there, 24/7 live stream from that prayer room. So that's number one of that campaign. Number two, with that extra income, we're also going to be able to do more events more often in more places. So all the places that I get invites from and our wonderful YouTube commenters and Facebook friends and people from all over are constantly asking, when are you coming here? When are you coming here? Well, help us do it. Become a $30 a month partner and we'll be able to do more events in more regions more often. So do that today. Ultimately, it's all for one thing. We want to win souls for the glory of God. That's it. We want to win souls. We want to build the kingdom. And help us do that by helping us expand with this ministry campaign. Again, we're less than 400 partners away. Sign up today to become a $30 a month partner. Partner with me. Help me take the gospel all around the world. Check this out. If you become a partner for $30 or more a month, that's a $30 monthly, not a one-time gift of $30, and a $30 monthly gift. For those who sign up to become a $30 a month partner or more, you get to pick a signed copy of either Carriers of the Glory or 25 Truths About Demons and Spiritual Warfare. Either way, we know you don't do it for the gift. We know you do it for the gospel, but we want to say thank you to those who do sign up. So sign up today. Do that right at the end of this video. A link's going to appear. Click that link right at the very end of this video. So stick around for that. And that is it for this edition of Spirit Church. Until next time, remember, nothing is impossible with God. Thank you for watching Encounter TV. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, help me win souls by spreading the gospel through events and media. Make a one-time donation or become a monthly supporter by clicking on the donate link now.